No one knows how it got there, but for several years, a dangerous invasive aquatic plant has been infesting the shallows of beautiful Lake Leelanau. Known to outgrow and outcompete native vegetation, Eurasian water milfoil creates dense underwater jungles and spreads like a mat at the surface of lakes. But the Lake Leelanau Lake Association says it's gone far enough. Together with the Grand Traverse Band of Ottawa and Chippewa Indians, they're intent on turning back this infestation.
But there were reports of Eurasian water milfoil fragments in the lake, and so we had a really strong suspicion that it was growing there somewhere.
That's Brian Price, biologist for the Lake Leelanau Lake Association and Project Mastermind.
We found one bed of milfoil near the Lake Leelanau Narrows, several other small clumps down the west side of the lake, and a very large infestation that stretches nearly a mile along the east side of the lake, right across from where we're standing.
According to Joe Latimer, an aquatic plant specialist with Michigan State University Extension, Eurasian water milfoil is a very serious and expensive threat to everyone who uses Lake Leelanau.
Eurasian milfoil will grow aggressively, it will grow thickly, and when it does that, it damages the habitat for the fish and other animals that live in the lake, and it will also harm our recreational activities on the lake. It's hard to get a boat through there, and if you think about it, that becomes part of the problem, because if boats running through a bed of water milfoil are what's most likely to spread it, and it's in a popular lake for boating, you know, the chances that someone will take their boat through there, get some milfoil tangled on their props or on the hull of their boat, you know, they're more likely to spread it to other parts of Lake Leelanau since it's such a very big lake, or when they leave the water and take their boat somewhere else, they may also spread it to other places. So, you know, there's a lot of concern there. And, you know, even for people who live on the lake, if you have a home on a beautiful section of Lake Leelanau and suddenly right in front there's mats of Eurasian milfoil growing to the surface and you can't even get your boat away from the dock, that's going to hurt your appreciation of your own property, but it also damages property values along the lake.
Apparently, the methods being used at Lake Leelanau are not well tested in Michigan. Early in their search for ways to control the invasive plant, the Lake Association ruled out chemical and biological controls and large harvesting machines.
So that boiled it down to two methods that we could possibly use if we ruled out chemicals and the mechanical harvesters. One is called the DASH system, which is diver-assisted suction harvesting. It's used in a lot of lakes. It's time intensive. It uses a diver to actually pull out the whole plant, roots, stem, the whole works, feed it into a suction tube, which takes it to the surface. That is a very friendly to the environment way to do this, but it tends to be expensive. The only other non-chemical method is to cover the bottom with some sort of barrier that deprives the plants of any light, killing them. And as far as we knew, barriers had been tried and are used on a consistent basis. There's a manufacturer in New Jersey that makes lake bottom blankets that are 40 feet long and 10 feet wide, commercially available. And there had been experimentation primarily by guys from the Nature Conservancy that are out of the Indiana office of the Nature Conservancy, their invasive species program. I'll give a shout out to Lindsay Chatterton and Andrew Tucker, who discussed barriers with us and steered us in a direction of investigating using biodegradable burlap barriers, possibly in addition to these synthetic barriers, which you remove again after they've killed the plants.
From the tribal perspective, this plant has an impact on the health of the ecosystem and the fishing opportunities in this lake.
That's Dan Mays, a fish and wildlife biologist for the Grand Traverse Band of Ottawa and Chippewa Indians.
Late 2019, Lake Leelanau Lake Association and Grand Traverse Band started working together and created a partnership and drafted a plan of action, a game plan for how we're going to handle this. And we were just successfully awarded funding through the Great Lakes Restoration Initiative to fund this project for 3 years.
But these are floating out here.
We're hoping in 3 years' time we can really stamp out this milfoil. And not only does the grant cover control, but also evaluation and research. And that's really important not only for Lake Leelanau, for lakes that are dealing with this issue throughout Michigan, throughout the region.
A contractor for this project, Mike Smith, is a diver and owner of MTT Dash Divers. For dash operations, he says, the most difficult infestations to deal with are near properties where fertilizers are used or septic systems are failing.
Well, what we do is we got a three-person crew. We have a service boat, a dash boat, and that we go out on. So we will place one diver in the water, and we have what's called surface applied air. It is the same setup that you would see for people that kind of do the gold mining on, like, I think it's Discovery Channel or whatever. It's pretty similar to what they do. So a diver will go down with the 6-inch suction harvesting hose. And as we go down, we'll pull the weeds at the roots, dig for the roots, try and take a level of soil off that might have any seeds that fell. It'll go up through the suction harvesting hose into a bagging system. And there'll be a person on the top that is moving doors, so it'll individually put the harvested milfoil into individual bags. Once those bags fill up, that bag comes out, goes onto the service boat. Once that service boat's filled, the other crew member takes it in, unloads it, and we continue diving and pulling. We've had some really good success for it. We've checked several of the spots that we've done previously, and the growth has been minimal. Some spots we've had zero growth, and a lot of it depends on the substrate and the use of the lake. You can certainly tell when somebody uses fertilizer on their property, especially on the lake side of the property, because that will obviously seep into the water, the runoff, and I mean, you can tell just diving when you're down there, when the substrate changes in front of somebody's property, that it goes to a real heavy muck and a lot more growth and a lot thicker growth in there. And the other part is, of course, we live in northern Michigan, especially some smaller lakes that don't have city septic services. And those septic tanks sometimes were cabins. You know, those houses could be cabins, and those septic tanks could be 100 years old or so. And those can leak in and also cause that substrate issue that's really a breeding ground for the milfoil.
Everybody that's tried using barriers says there's one real big problem with it. And that is that they're very difficult to get in the water the right way, get them where you want them, get them anchored down. And the only advantage that I could see that we had is that I used to be a commercial fisherman. And we kind of specialize in getting big stuff in the water and getting it in there in the right shape. And so I thought, we can figure out a way to do this. The Lake Leelanau Lake Association made a decision that we were going to buy synthetic barriers and buy large burlap tarps that were fitted to what we know about the size and dimension of these particular beds of Eurasian water milfoil. My notes from last year show that I thought they were like 40 feet wide, stretching out considerable distances and running fairly straight on the bottom. So I got the biggest burlap tarps that I thought we could deploy in the lake, and figured that we'll find out how to put them in there. And so that's what we did. We ordered 40-foot by 400-foot long burlap barriers from a place called Dayton Bag down in Ohio. And they sewed them together and they shipped them up in the spring. And we've determined a couple things. We can get them in. We can get them in straight. We can cover the stuff we want to cover. We got them anchored down. We're gonna try to also weight them down so we can pull the anchors and use them elsewhere. Every one of our anchors, you know, we don't want to leave anything in the lake. Everything's supposed to be biodegradable. So we're gonna leave in a few rocks and sandbags that might be holding these things down, but we're not gonna leave any metal. We're not gonna leave any plastic. We're not gonna leave anything in the lake except stuff that's gonna break down. It remains to be seen how well large deployments of burlap will actually kill the milfoil. You look at it, and we inspected the barriers we put in, and they look like they should kill anything under there. We'll see. This is an experiment. If all goes well, we will have added to the arsenal